So streaming to YouTube doesn't need to be difficult. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to connect YouTube into OBS Studio and the best settings to be able to utilize to have high quality, professional looking streams on YouTube. And if you're new here, welcome to the Streamer Academy, where I help you start, create, and grow your stream. So go ahead and check out thestreameracademy.com for tons of resources to help you grow your stream. So the first thing that we're gonna do is you want to have OBS open. We're gonna come to the bottom right and we're gonna select settings. This is where a big bulk of the adjustments of getting everything connected is going to happen. We're gonna come to the left-hand side and we're gonna select stream. Where it says service, we wanna select YouTube RTMPS. This is then gonna ask you to go ahead and use a stream key or to be able to connect your account. I encourage you to use the connect account, because what it does is that it then brings in the YouTube chat into OBS Studio as well, allowing you to be able to manage it, to respond, and then you can also schedule your live streams directly inside of OBS Studio as well. So go ahead and select connect account recommended. It's gonna go ahead and ask you to get logged in. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna select your email that you have for your YouTube channel. You're gonna allow OBS to be able to go ahead and continue. You'll press continue, it'll ask you to log in. You may have to provide some authentication. And then once you're done, you'll see a screen that says authorization completed successfully. You can now close this page. So we'll come here back to OBS Studio. And now you'll see here that your account is connected. So we wanna select ignore streaming services using recommendations. We'll select that because we're gonna put custom settings that's gonna make our stream look professional. So we'll simply select okay. And you'll see here that our chat now comes up. So what you can do is you can drag this and you can go ahead and place it on the left-hand side and you can adjust this here. Okay, and it says here, once a broadcast has been created, your live chat will appear here. Okay, so every minute you go live, the chat's gonna pop up here and you'll be able to go ahead and do that. This is the YouTube Live control panel. This is optional if you want to be able to use it. And again, this is gonna give you again some additional features for you to be able to see and monitor for your stream. And if you do want that, you'll simply go through the same process and log in again. Now, I personally don't use it, so I just like to have my chat, like to have my horizontal, and I like to have my vertical as well here whenever I'm streaming. So now, just connecting over YouTube to OBS does not make your stream look good. We need to go ahead and adjust some settings to make sure that it works out right. So we'll come back to settings here. We'll go to where it says output, and we're gonna go ahead and select advanced under output mode. Now, everything up to this point is exactly the same. This is where it changes whether you're on Mac or you're on Windows. So I'm gonna share both settings for you, and then based on what you're utilizing, copy those settings for the best looking stream. So the first thing here is that if you're on a Mac, you're gonna follow these exact settings here. You're gonna have your audio encoder on ACC. Your video encoder needs to be Apple VT H.264 hardware encoder. Super important. Your rate control, CBR. Your bit rate here, you don't have to have it at 9,000. Okay, you can if you can afford it, but you can really put it at 6,000. This is gonna give you a good stream. And you may be asking, how do you determine whether or not you can have 6,000, 9,000, or even more? And the way you do that is by checking your internet speed. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to speedtest.net. And I'm gonna put a link in the description of this video. You're gonna hit the big button in the middle that says go. Once you hit go, that's gonna give you your download and your upload speed. The big number that you wanna focus on is your upload, okay? The most important thing here is that this number should be at minimum 10, okay? It should be 10.00. The higher, the better. If you have at least 10, you can use 6,000, you can use 9,000, kind of, but you don't really need that much of a range. So go ahead and check that. Once you check that, then you can come back and follow these settings here. So once you determine your upload speed, we go ahead and put it at 6,000. Keyframe intervals, you're gonna put it at 2. Profile is gonna be at high, and you're gonna use B frames, okay? These are gonna be your settings if you're on a Mac. If you're on a Windows, these are the settings that you're gonna go ahead and utilize. So you're gonna go ahead and keep it at advanced. You're gonna use the audio encoder, you're gonna use ACC. Your video encoder, you're gonna use NVIDIA NVIC H.264. If you don't have a really good graphics card, you can select HX264, okay? And that's gonna be decent enough for you to be able to go ahead and stream. And then for your rate control, you're gonna use constant bit rate. Again, we're gonna follow the 6,000 for this. You're gonna do keyframe intervals, you're gonna put it at 2. Your preset, you're gonna put it at P5 slow. Now again, if you have a really good PC, you can go ahead and even go to P7. If you go to P7, that's gonna be the best quality, the more strain on your computer. If you go P1, it's gonna be less quality, it's gonna be smoother, but it's gonna require less resources on your PC. I like to keep it at P5. Tuning, put it at high quality. Multi-pass mode, 2 passes. Profile high, uncheck look ahead. Adaptive quantization, put it on, and then brief frames, put it at 2. If you follow these settings right here, whether you're on Mac or you're on Windows, this is gonna give you the smoothest experience on YouTube. You're gonna look great on camera, your screen's gonna look good, and it's gonna be a great experience for your viewers. So once you've gone ahead and set up those settings there, we're gonna come to apply, and you're gonna select okay, and then we're gonna come back into the settings just one more time, and we're gonna wanna make sure you have your audio destination set up correctly. So your desktop audio, you wanna make sure you select your desktop audio, and then for your microphone, you wanna make sure you utilize your microphone that you utilize here. Now, this can be your Rodecaster, it can be any mic that you have connected to your computer. You select that, press okay, and now we have the best settings here. Now you can just simply click start streaming to go live and not have to worry about any of the issues here. Now again, you can go ahead and set this up inside of YouTube, or you can do it here inside of OBS. You can select manage broadcast, and this is gonna give you the option to be able to select your title. So we can type in here test title. You can put in your description. Now, if you have default descriptions and things that you normally utilize, I encourage you to set this up inside of YouTube, and then you can go ahead and select existing broadcast, and you'll be able to use it there. However, you can put a description here. You can decide if this is gonna be public, unlisted, or private. Super important. You select private, only you're gonna be able to see it. You select unlisted, only people who have access to the link can see it. Public is gonna be available to everyone, and it's gonna put it into the algorithm as well. Then you select your category. You wanna select no, it's not made for kids, or yes, it's made for kids, based on what it is that you're doing. You can then go ahead and upload your thumbnail. And then for latency, you wanna go ahead and put it at ultra low, especially if we're streaming at 1080p, 60 frames per second, which is the stream settings that I gave you. This is gonna make it to where when people type in chat, you're able to respond right away. So there's the lowest amount of latency between when somebody chats with you and what's happening on stream and what's actually happening in real time. Then you can go ahead and schedule this for later, or you can go ahead and create the broadcast and start streaming, or just simply create the broadcast and come back to it later. So you can select that. Once you have that in place, you can go ahead and hit start streaming, and now you're good to go. However, okay, you don't want to just go live without having a professional looking stream. So you can see here that I have a graphics, I have my gameplay, I have my camera showing here for me as well. So if you want to have a professional looking live stream with graphics and overlays, go ahead and watch this video right here, where I walk you step by step on how to add all your overlays, alerts, your chat, your starting soon, everything that you need to make your stream look professional in this video right here. I'll see you guys in the next video.